Well, the latest hacking comes on the heels of major security breaches at Target, Home Depot, and Staples, just to name a few.
So how easy is it for thieves to access your personal information? KARE11 investigative reporter A.J. Legault shows us.
It's very brazen. Dates of births.
Your online.
Bank account numbers.
And undercover.
So you can buy dumps, which is just cards in bulk.
Inside a modern-day den of thieves.
This is like the Yellow Pages.
A place sophisticated criminals go when they want to steal your identity.
It's essentially everything that a criminal would need to do a complete identity theft.
A report of massive security breach at Target.
It's been nearly a year since thieves hacked into Target's computer system during the hectic holiday shopping season, stealing millions of credit card numbers. So we wondered, who's winning the war to protect your pocketbook now?
I'm very irritated and I want to bust these guys.
Our search for answers begins on the front lines at Quantum Merchant Services. Rob Olson runs the Twin Cities company that sets up the systems that let businesses swipe and process credit cards. A business called Trimline Painting is trying to set up an account. It sent the owner's name, an address, a social security number.
He gave me the person's name and business name and phone number. And even a check, a voided check from what he says is from this business for one person.
It may look legit, but Rob is suspicious because now the man is using a credit card with a different name. His application says he's Jeffrey Collins, but the name on the card is Francois Grobler.
The names are different.
The number that was getting used is 43.
When we track down and call the real Mr. Grobler, we discover he doesn't work for a painting company, and he's never heard of Jeffrey Collins.
No, I do not know Jeffrey Collins.
His credit card, apparently stolen.
I'm flabbergasted.
And before Grobler's stolen card, the thief had tried using a different one belonging to this man who asked we not reveal his name.
So I was really horrified when
we alerted him, he discovered he'd already been billed for two phony charges.
So the two charges together were almost $2,000.
And when we dug deeper, we discovered the man claiming to be Jeffrey Collins from Elmira, New York, was using a phone through the internet. His email is from Canada, and by now he's tried to use credit cards stolen from people in Long Island, Utica, New York, and Champaign, Illinois. If Rob Olson hadn't gotten suspicious, the crook could have set up a business account that would have let him ring up hundreds of phony credit card charges.
Sets up the merchant account, takes the stolen credit cards, runs those credit cards through that merchant account.
And keep pocketing stolen money for days.
They'll do this until the wheels fall off.
So how hard is it for thieves to get stolen credit cards? Just look.
They sell stolen credit cards.
Our guide is Mark Lanterman, a former member of a federal task force that tracked online criminals. Using a fake name of his own, Lanterman has logged into a website that sells stolen credit cards to thieves by the thousands.
I would call this a Amazon.com for credit card thieves.
If you're a thief, you can pick the country, the state, even the town where you want your stolen cards to be from.
It's not hidden at all.
Choose between debit cards, credit cards, almost any type of card.
The hacker can choose what type of card. Is it an ATM? Is it a business card? Is it a platinum card?
Mark Lanterman says this website is based in Russia, beyond the reach of U.S. law enforcement. It's run by the same hacker who's thought to be responsible for breaking into Target. And with dozens of security breaches since then, from Michaels to Staples to Home Depot, there are millions of cards to choose from. Just watch what happens when we search for stolen credit cards from Minnetonka.
Not Minneapolis, not St. Paul, just a suburb of Minneapolis. And there are thousands for sale.
Just in this one little suburb.
Just in this one suburb.
What's a stolen credit card here cost? As little as $5.
That's incredible.
And believe it or not, if a thief buys a card that's already been canceled, there's even a money-back guarantee.
Is this honesty among thieves? Or?
It is credibility among thieves.
And big stores aren't the only places hackers attack. Your doctor's office or insurance agent often keep more information about you.
There's more to cybercrime than just stolen credit card numbers.
Including your social security number. everything a crook would need to open up new accounts in your name.
It can be devastating to a consumer.
And that brings us back to Jeffrey Collins, the name being used to open the credit processing account.
Hi, Mr. Collins.
We tracked down the real Jeffrey, who'd had his identity completely stolen. He contacted police, and now there's a grand jury investigation underway. But experts say, even today, a year after Target, authorities are still playing an online version of whack-a-mole, often with thieves overseas.
And not much that law enforcement here in the U.S. can do?
There's nothing at all that law enforcement can do against this site.
Not what you want to hear, is it? The battle over stolen credit information certainly appears to be being won by the bad guys. So you're probably asking, what can I do to protect myself? Well, the best advice we learned is always use your credit card and never a debit card when you make purchases. That way, at the very least, the thieves are not cleaning out your bank account. With a credit card, you can dispute the charges and usually get them removed.
So is the answer the chip that we're hearing about in these cards? Is that what's going to keep everybody safer?
That's a great question, and it certainly could. And our expert was even mentioning the new Apple product that he says that may revolutionize how this is done and maybe protect consumers more, but that just remains to be seen.
Yeah. It's all in the process of being changed over. So in the meantime, thanks for the education,
yes.
AJ.
Keep your wallet tight.
Yes.
Thanks.